This is the first practical video in respect to C14 calibration, and we will start with how you can combine two dates from which, and I have to repeat that again, from which you are sure that they date the same event. So it is impossible in respect to dates that come from the same individual. If you have the same or different bones from the same individual and you are perfectly sure that they belong to each other, you can use the combine function. Or if you have, for example, cereals from one deposit where you're sure that this is one harvest, you can also use the combine function to come up with a more precise C14 calibration. And for this, and also for all the other experiments that we will do here and demonstrations, I will use the dates from this Miskovice site, for which I probably don't know if this is correct or not, but here it just depends, or it's only necessary to show you how you can technically do that. Okay, let's assume we have these dates here, and we know that these two first dates here can be combined because they represent the same event. Probably they come from the same individual, are probably two different bones from the same individual, and we have these two different dates, and we will come up with a more precise date. So if we just individually calibrate them, I can click here on this arrow, and you can see here the calibration result of the individual dates. And also, if we go to single plot, we can see that there is quite a spread of the initial calibration here if we look at the individual dates individually. If we know that these belong to the same individual, we can insert a new function here. And I will start with using the graphical user interface, but you will soon see that most of the stuff is much easier and much faster if you do that directly in the code. So we click on insert, and then if I open up this drop down, you can see here are a lot of different options that you can use in respect to making more elaborated models in OxCal. But here we just want to combine two dates, so I choose combine and I can give this a name. Let's say I call that individual one, and I can insert this here. And now I have this frame here in which I can put individual C14 dates. So let's assume I will take this date here, and I can use this copy button here, click here and paste the date in, and I do the same for this other date. Copy, click on this empty button here and paste this in here. And now I have this combine for this individual with these two dates. I could now delete these two other dates, but we leave them there to get an idea how the difference will be between the individual dates here. For this, I delete all the other dates that we have, only these two independent dates and the combined result here. Let's have a short glimpse on the code. You can see it's rather trivial. We have here the code for the R date. We have seen that already. R date, name, BP and standard deviation. You have to make sure that brackets all are matching. That's the most difficult part here. And then we have combine, and in the round brackets, the name of the combined result. And then we have these curly brackets, and inside of these curly brackets are the individual dates here. So you could directly type into the code, or you can see the code here after you inserted it, and for example copy and paste code directly back and forth here. And most of the time that's much faster than do that with this graphical user interface. Okay, let's run this model or this calibration. And we can see now here the first individual date. We have seen that before with quite a spread of 200 or nearly 300 years. And the second date here with also a spread of actually more than this 300 years. And now the combined date, it's more condensed because it consists of both these dates, and all the probabilities that are overlapping are removed here. And we can see that there is a smaller peak here, especially we can see that in the multiplot. So here are the original dates. Here is the combined result. And in this light gray, we can see the constrained uncombined result, and in a darker gray we can see what combine produces after combining these two dates in the way how I described that in the theoretical video. Okay, also we can see that in the table where we can see the combined, the modeled results here. And you can see that Oxcal gives us a warning here that there are duplicates of the name. That's not a surprise because we have pasted in the same dates multiple times here. So with that, this is not a problem here. If these two dates are too far apart from a reasonable point of view, then also there will be a warning that these dates are not possible to combine. Well, let's try this out and say here 2000 something, and I run this again, and now I get here the warning zero distribution and here a lot of warnings for the combination here. So this is an indication that something must be wrong with the dates, they should not be combined. But the main reason not to combining dates is externally that you don't know that these dates belong to each other and date the same individual. Okay, so far for the combine. It can be a valuable tool, but you can also do a lot of not very reasonable things with that, so handle that with care and use that only in situations where you're sure that it is possible to combine these individual dates.